Hey guys, and welcome back to more Fire Emblem Echoes. So last time we finished the boss game, and today I said I was gonna play DLC, but I figured there is something on the main game we have not yet done, and that's watch the memory prisms. So memory prisms are like flashbacks of events that happened in the past, and they serve to give you some background on certain stories and characters. I believe the main game has 10 of them, and there is a few that are DLC, but the DLC ones, we're gonna watch them when we play the DLC. So, I think I have them all. Let's see. 3, 6, 9, and 10, yeah. Alright, I don't know if they're in order, so I guess we're gonna find that out now.
Princess Antiz!
Who are you?
I am Sir Meissen, Your Highness. I served your father as a knight. I'm here to take you to safety. Come with me. You were very brave to hang on all by yourself, Your Highness. Anything bad happen to you. Now take my hand, quickly.
What's happening?
Damn you to say. He aims to leave no witnesses alive. I'm afraid things may get a little bumpy, Your Highness. Whatever you do, don't leave my side.
I won't. Oh, but wait. Where's my brother? Where's Conrad? Sir Meissen, you have to save my brother, please!
Your Highness, I checked every room on my way to you. There are none left alive. It pains me to say this, but I fear Conrad is no longer with us.
No! No! Conrad!
Where's the princess? Desaye's orders are to bring back her head, so somebody find her now!
The time for grief will come, Princess. For now, you must survive. Come, we must be off.
All right, I'm coming.
Damn, poor Selige. Yeah, that must be when Desaye took over the castle. And then I guess Meissen went to Ram Village after that.
Clive! Fernand, you came! Of course I did. I am honored to finally be able to call myself a Knight of Sophia. Alas, I fear I'm going to incur your family's wrath anew for this. They blame me for every reckless thing you've ever done. What choice did I have? Am I to while away the time frolicking with my sister? Unfortunately, she's never been one for climbing trees or playing at the river. She's nothing like your Claire. I fear my mother has about given up on my dear sister. She worries she'll never marry her off to a proper family. If Claire hears you've joined the Knights, she's liable to try and follow. She does abhor being left behind. I've no doubt Claire will come to her senses. She's at the age where girls learn to embroider and be demure. She'll soon realize it best to leave the kingdom to us men.
Embroidery needles are just weapons to her. But we've other matters to discuss. Tell me, old friend. Perhaps this is not a matter I should speak of. Especially not while I serve his majesty himself. But to say his swift rise at court troubles me. For all intents and purposes, he now rules the kingdom. Aye, he's a cunning one. He has been putting pressure on my father as well, much to his chagrin. No wonder, your father is a good and kind man. He doubtless has no desire to put his own people through such hardship. But he would be wise not to incur Desaye's displeasure. Not these days. I hope he knows how to play his cards.
As do I.
We all know what happened to Sir Meissen, after all. It's a damned unfortunate business, all of it. I'm certain Sir Meissen would have led His Majesty down a wiser path. But now that he's been driven off, there is no point lamenting it. If only that were the worst of it. Now that the King's scions are no more, what becomes of the royal bloodline? The Knights of Sophia need a true king to protect, not a laughingstock. Mind your words, Fernand. The king is yet young. He can produce more heirs. And while we cannot choose our king, we can still serve our people. The nobles of Sophia have a duty to her small folk. On that, we agree. King or no, it's the kingdom itself that is most worth protecting. Now, are you going to tell me how things are done around here or not? Let me get you settled.
Huh. Well, I guess they are in chronological order then, because obviously... Well, Desai has not taken the castle yet. I guess Selga was on another, like, castle or fortress or something. Alright, that's interesting. Also, the discussion they had about Claire marrying or not marrying someone from a proper house. I wonder what her mother's reaction to the marriage with Grey. Interesting. I have this stance. I think this one is weird but good.
You there. What are you doing?
Lord Rakut! Pray forgive me, my lord. I did not mean to give offense.
Not at all. I approached you. It seems a terrible waste that you would come to a ball just to be alone.
Perhaps. But mine is a lesser house, and I do not seem to find much favor here. In the end, I tired of all the eyes on me and retreated.
You are mistaken, my lady. You were invited here. You have the right to carry yourself as anyone else.
As you say, my lord.
Do you not like dancing?
My lord? That is to say, I love to dance. In most circumstances. There is a little grove behind my manor. Inside is a flower garden where small birds gather. It is a place dear to me. On days of fine weather, I go there alone and dance until my feet... Oh, forgive me. You must find this all so terrifically dull.
On the contrary.
Hmm?
Tell me your name.
It's Renea, my lord.
Renea. A lovely name. Renea, may I have the next dance?
What? You mean with me? Oh, I couldn't possibly. I mean, what would people think?
Then we can dance here, away from prying eyes and wagging tongues. That is, if you do not mind the absence of your garden and birds.
Lord Rakut, you are too sweet.
I pray that is a yes. I am the Emperor's nephew, after all. To refuse me would be most uncouth.
I would love to dance with you, my lord. Shall we?
My lady.
Tips Fedora. Well, well. You know, it's kind of weird to see a cutscene with Berkut that doesn't involve him getting salty over something. That was kind of cute.
Rudolph, are you here? It's me, Meissen. I've come here as promised.
Ah, Meissen. It has been too long. Thank you for answering my call.
There you are, my friend. I must say, I never thought I would set foot on Regellian soil again. Now, pray tell, what was so urgent that you summoned me here? I know it cannot be to simply reminisce on days gone by.
Alas, I fear not. Meissen, in all my years, I have never known a truer friend than you. You are the only man I can trust with this. Here.
An infant? Rudolph, is this your...
My son, yes. He was only just born. His name is Alm. I want you to take him to Sophia and raise him as your own.
Are you mad? What father would hand off his newborn child? I love you most dear, but I must know the reason for this request.
Yes, the reason. Alm here is destined to one day champion Valentia.
How can you know this?
Look at his left hand.
The brand.
Indeed. Two children with such a mark are prophesied to save Valentia from ruin. And now my son has been born with it. I also hear tale of a newborn Zofian princess who has this selfsame mark.
Two children. Then Valentia's end is drawing near. Is Duma's madness to blame?
Yes, his time is running short.
I see.
Meissen, I have to draw first blood. I must awaken the people to their potential, their own strength, and stop them from leaning so hard on the blessings and precepts of gods. I know the people will rise up against me for what I do. But as a father, nothing would make me prouder than for Alm to lead them.
Rudolph.
Promise me, my friend. Promise you will shape my boy into a true champion before that day comes. If he stays in Regel, the Duma faithful will doubtless attempt to take his life. I want none to know of him, so he has a chance to grow up hale and happy. This is the only thing I can do for him as his father.
Very well, my friend. I promise to take care of him. I'll do what it takes to make him the finest champion Valentia could ask for.
Thank you, Meissen. Goodbye, Alm. May you never forget how to be kind. When next we meet, my son, it will be on the fields of war.
Rudolph.
Man, I wish some of these weren't like optional, but rather they actually played on the main story. Because for me, Rudolph's plan never made sense. Like, the dude takes a huge gamble. Pretty much, you have to dodge a 90% and hit with a 1% crit. Kind of gamble. Because what would have happened if Alm didn't grow up to be what he wanted? Pretty much Valentia goes to shit. So yeah, I don't know. All game writing, I guess. Alright, let's continue.
Conrad? Conrad! Where in the world did he go?
Wait, is that Antiz? Antiz, is that you?
Conrad? I can hear you, but I don't... Where are you?
Good morning?
Morning? It's past noon. What were you doing under the bed?
I was hiding so the ghost wouldn't take me away.
What ghost?
Mother told me all about it. She said that if I'm bad, a ghost will come for me in the night. It'll come down from Fear Mountain in Regel and take me away.
Oh, you're so lucky. Your mother's Regelian, so she has all sorts of fun stories.
Fun? So you're not scared of the ghost?
No, why would I be? I haven't done anything bad. Have you done something bad?
Well, I kinda accidentally broke the vase in the Great Hall. Then I cleaned up all the pieces and buried them in the garden.
That was you? The servants were looking everywhere for that vase. We have to go tell them.
But I'll get in trouble.
They'll be fine, Conrad. I'll go with you. We'll apologize and they'll forgive us. I promise. Besides, if you don't, that ghost is sure to come and get you tonight!
No! If it took me away, I wouldn't be able to play with you anymore.
Right? And I don't want you to go away either. So then, shall we go?
All right.
Let's hurry and put this all behind us.
Wait. I'm kind of scared. Can I hold your hand?
Conrad, you... Oh, all right.
Oh, ain't that cute. Well, I guess these are not in order. Because this one obviously happens before this one happened. And this one as well. But yeah, I don't know why. This one feels a bit more morbid after watching this one, because it's like, well, the ghost did indeed came for Conrad. Just not in the way Celica was like thinking. Anyway, let's continue.
You ain't getting away from me, girlie. I'll truss you up all pretty and tight and add you to Grease collection.
Mila, hear my prayer. Aid your humble servant in her hour of need. Ah! Huh?
Hooey! That was a close one. You good there, beautiful?
E.
E?
Yeah!
What? Hey, hold on, wait! I'm not one of those jerks. I came to help you.
Did you know? My apologies, then. I thought you were another of those unwashed rogues.
Wow, that's harsh. But enough about my feelings. I'm just glad you're okay.
I am. Though, alas, I fear I've made a poor job of showing my gratitude. My name is Silk, and you are?
Jesse, just another mercenary of the unwashed rogue variety. I saw some undesirables follow you out of Zofia Harbor. So I followed them, and here we are. Guess I was right to check it out.
I didn't notice I was being followed, let alone by two different parties. I had thought myself a more canny traveler than that. The fault was mine for letting my guard down so poorly.
That happens to the best of us. So where is it you're headed to?
Yes, of course. I'm headed for Ram Village. I have something I must deliver there.
You mean that village way down south? Yeah, I think you took a wrong turn.
Oh? I didn't realize. I'm ashamed to admit I got a bit turned around as I was fleeing those bandits.
Well, let me see you back as far as Zofia Harbor. Least I could do.
Oh? Your help would be most welcome. If you truly don't mind, that is. Though, may I ask why you offer such kindness to a stranger?
I need a reason? Well, I don't think it's anything too complicated. I mean, every guy wants to play the hero in front of a pretty lady, no?
Sir!
So don't sweat being an imposition. My motives are purely selfish. You get safe passage, and I get to show off what a charming guy I am.
You're candid, if not else. But very well. I accept your offer.
That's what I was hoping to hear.
I would hate to disappoint. May Mila's blessing shine extra bright upon Jesse's path. He sorely needs it.
Hmm? What'd you say?
Oh, nothing. Nothing at all.
And after that, Jesse ends up in jail. So much for the Mila's blessing. You know, this makes me think that it's kind of a shame that there isn't really more interactions between Alm's party and Celica's party, because they meet at literally the final map. I don't know, I think it would have been neat to have more interactions between them.
Another day of fine weather. I love stretching my legs in the morning. Perhaps I'll gather some shells. Huh? Who's there? He appears badly wounded. Is he dead? He's alive! Are you all right? Stay with me!
Nina...
Huh? Is that someone's name? What am I doing? I need to go get help before he keels over. I'll be right back. You just hold on.
Where am I?
You're awake. Oh, thank goodness. I thought you were dead for sure. I found you collapsed by the shore earlier. You were gravely injured.
Who are you?
My name is Tatiana. I work here at the church. What's your name?
My name is...
Yes?
cannot remember. Who am I? From whence did I come? These things are a mystery to me.
Oh, goodness. You're one of those types.
I apologize for the trouble.
It's all right. It seems as if everyone's losing their memory in these times. Still, how are we going to inform your family that you're safe? They must be worried sick. Oh, yes, that is to say, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to give you something else to fret over. I'm sure we'll get it all worked out. You should rest in the meantime.
Yes, rest.
You'll be all right. I know you will. I'm taking care of you now, after all.
You would do that?
It would be my honor. You can stay here as long as you like, even after you get better. Of course, once you're on your feet, there's cleaning to do, wood to chop. But your only job right now is to heal.
Why are you being so kind to me? What am I to you but a stranger? Another gaping maw to feed.
I wasn't aware kindness needed an explanation beyond itself. When someone is in trouble, you help them. That's common decency. And from the moment I saw you, I knew I couldn't leave you.
What?
Well, I could see you were hurting. And, not just on the surface. Oops, I really need to stop laying on the misery. Sorry again. But I am here to help you. I mean it. So lean on me, and let me be your crutch for as long as it takes.
Thank you, Tatiana.
That's how he got there. You know, I was hoping when Tatiana said that he had a grave injury or something, he would say, that's a seriously bad injury. And they should have worked in the pun in there. Alright. Leaving the past behind.
Do you think you might be able to pick up the pace, Python?
I could consider it, if we hadn't been marching non-stop since yesterday.
I'm sorry, are you whining? Was that a whine? In case it slipped your mind, the fate of all Zofia is at stake. We must join the Deliverance and do our part. Now show a little backbone.
This is gonna snap my backbone. Are you really so keen on joining up?
I am. Why? Are you getting cold feet?
Course not. But joining the Deliverance ain't exactly a whopper of an idea, if you ask me. I hear they're a bunch of mamby-pamby knights and stuck-up young nobles. Which means you and me are walking halfway across Zofia just to be snubbed.
They would never do that! Probably. At least I hope not.
See? The only future you got there is as a peon among peons.
I admit, you could be right. But I also hear their leader, Sir Clive, is a just and reasonable man. I wager he'll judge us based on what we can do and not the station of our birth. Or perhaps you'd rather turn around and continue working for Lord Dunderhead.
Not bloody likely. So, is leaving the soldier game for good completely off the table at this point?
You're welcome to return home and be a carpenter like your father.
Huh? The only thing I hate more than swords is hammers.
There you go, then. You're a gifted archer, so use the gifts you have. You won't catch me running home to be some bookworm like my sire. I've made a name for myself as a warrior. May as well take that to its logical conclusion and do some more warring.
Everything has to be a step forward for you.
In truth, I'm too scared to begin questioning myself now.
You? Scared? Well, slap my butt and call me a rented mule.
I try to keep it to a minimum. Now walk, mule! Walk! The Deliverance hideout is just beyond these woods. We should attempt to reach it before the sun abandons us.
Yes, my lord. Right away, my lord.
Oh man, I really like what they did with Forza and Python in this game. They complement each other so well. Their support is also pretty good, so... pretty good one.
Chancellor Desai? Chancellor! It's me, Lord Chancellor. Sir Slade, you,
Ask for me, my lord?
You've arrived. Good.
My lord, may I ask why you wanted to meet me here?
The castle has far too many ears, and what I say is meant for yours alone. I have a mission for you. One that must be carried out in secret. Prince Conrad and Princess Antiz. You are to go to the villa where they reside and put them to the sword.
My lord, that's... You want me to assassinate the king's own children?
Do it. And when this sorry business is over, you shall be my right-hand man. Lands, titles, the world has great things in store for you, Slade.
Of course, my lord. May I presume to, presume that you were behind the untimely demise of the king's other scions?
Presume what you will. I do the world a service by purging it of Lima's incompetent bloodline. Only one man is fit to rule Zofia, and you stand in his presence. Or do you disagree?
No, my lord. Agreed on all fronts. Was about to say as much myself, so I was. But doesn't the king's bloodline descend from Milla herself? Incompetent though Lima may be, the mother won't take kindly to his death.
Do not speak to me of mothers. I never suckled at that monster's teat. Why should I fear a goddess too busy sleeping to leave her temple? The age of worrying about what the gods think of us has come to an end. The kingdom of Zofia needs a strong will to set it back on course. My will!
Well said, my lord. Hear, hear. I would be honored to aid you in all of your noble ambitions.
Then see it done on the day after next. That's when Lima and his guard go to the temple for rites. Oh, and Slade. Kill everyone at the villa. I want not a single life spared. There can be no witnesses.
Understood, my lord.
You know, if I didn't know any better, that scene kind of looked like something that would come out of the DLC from the Deliverance DLC. Like as a cutscene. You know, they say his ambitions are actually kind of similar to what Rudolf wanted though. Like, not depend on the gods and stuff like that. Obviously, he did it completely the wrong way, like killing so many. Alright, a land of gods and men. I think this is the one we got in the after the Grima fight.
Oh, Duma, why can you not understand? All living things are deserving of happiness. We can build that paradise for them here, in Valentia, a world free of misery.
Nonsense! A world without misery is not the same as a happy one. Misery shapes men throughout their lives. Hardship makes them strong. Smother them with blessings, and they will never learn what happiness is.
So you would temper them with misfortune instead? Mankind faces trials enough without us burdening them yet more. I wish to be their salvation, the hands that dispel their grief and pain. It is our duty as gods to save them.
Poor foolish Milla. Your love would only make them soft and lead them to depravity and ruin. Men are weak. Our duty as gods is to make them strong. Our hands must be firm.
Duma, my dear brother, I'd hoped we could unite and make Valentia the utopia it was meant to be. But I see now that our argument will only continue in circles.
So it seems. I cannot even remember how long it has been, my sister. How long since we left our old world behind and came here to build anew. Regardless, it is clear the utopia you desire is not the same as mine. We must part ways. Let me rule the north, and you shall have the south. Let us vow to each seek our own ideals, and never trample upon the others. We shall at time judge which of us has done right by mankind. Do we have an accord?
I tire of our fighting, my brother. An accord it shall be. Farewell, Duma. May your people find as much happiness as mine.
I mean, didn't really tell us anything new, per se. It's just the accord that we already know about. But oh well, I guess it was cool to see Duma in a human version of him. Well, human-ish. Alright, those are all the memory prisms that you get from the main game. So, wow, that actually took half an hour. Alright, well, I guess we'll leave it that here, and next time we're gonna start with the Deliverance DLC. So look forward to that. Thanks for watching, guys, and I will see you next time.